In this chapter, we'll be looking at loops in Python. So Python executes statements sequentially. That means the first line would be executed and then it will go to the second line, then third line, and then the execution follows the other lines. And when it executes a certain line, it will never come back to that line. Instead, if you want Python to loop over certain statements repeatedly, that means you want to rerun a block of code multiple times. So this you can do by looping through that block of code. Now, in order to loop the program, you have certain functions available. So first is while loop. So if you use this while loop, a group of statements will be repeated until the given condition is true. So the Python comes out of the loop only when the given condition is false. Until the condition is true, it goes on running the block of code within this while loop. Similarly, there is for loop, where a sequence of statements are executed multiple times. And here what happens is actually you'll be referring to the object within a list, or if you want to iterate over a tuple, if you want to iterate over a list, then in that situations, for loop will be useful. Next, you can have multiple loops inside a loop. So that we call it as nested loop. Let us see all these loops with the help of examples here. So as seen above, while loop, a code within while loop gets executed continuously until the condition becomes true. So the syntax would be like this: while an expression is tested, and if this expression becomes true, or the result of this expression becomes true, then this body of this while loop gets executed. See the example here. First, we are declaring a variable n whose value is equal to 10. Now, what we want to achieve here is we want to add all the numbers starting from 1 until 10. So to achieve that, we have given a condition: while I is less than or equal to 10. So I, we are initiating it with 1, and then n, we are initiating it with 10. So while 1 is not equal to 10, sorry, while 1 is less than or equal to 10. So we are incrementing I and we are adding the number to the previous number here. So by the time I becomes 10, this condition becomes false. So sorry, by the time I becomes 11, then this condition becomes false and then it gets out of this while loop. So here, after adding all the numbers from 1 to 10, next the value of I is incremented and the value of I becomes 11. Now, since 11 less than or equal to 10 is false, this while loop is broken and the control comes to this print. Now, whatever the sum is there within this variable, that gets printed here. Next is infinite loop. If the condition provided in while is true always, the loop gets run indefinitely. So we need to put some condition here so that after performing our task, this condition should get negated or this condition should become false. That is what we have done here. So initially value of I was 1 and n was 10. Now we have incremented it so that the value of I becomes greater than 10 and this becomes false. Only when this becomes false, this while loop execution will get stopped and then the control moves on to the next line. Otherwise it will result into an infinite loop. So see the example here. Now variable var contains a value 1, and until this variable contains 1, the Python should execute these two statements. And since variable contains 1, this statement will always be true, and this results in an indefinite loop. That means Python will go on running this code and it will go on giving you the output. So there is no way to break this now. So you should have already put a condition here that this condition will get false. Only when this condition becomes false, Python will come out of this loop and then prints this line. So while writing a code, you should keep this in mind that at certain point of time after achieving your task, the condition should become false. Now, after coming out of the while loop, when the condition is false, after coming out of the while loop, if you want any other task to achieve, you can put that within the else block. So counter was zero, and you are incrementing that counter every time when Python comes into this loop. So until counter is less than three, it will print inside loop and inside loop. Now, when the value of counter becomes three, so three less than three, it becomes false. So it will directly get into this else block. So that is the reason for the fourth time, the control went into the else block and this statement got printed inside else. So you can combine else statement with while loop also. Now next we have for loop. So this is to iterate over all the object within a list, tuple or string or any other object in which you can iterate. For that thing, you can use the for loop. So this variable, it points to the object within the sequence. See this example here, you'll get a clear picture. So I've taken a list and the name of that list is numbers. And within that list, I have numbers ranging from 1 to 9. Now for value in numbers. So what this statement tells is, first it will go and point to numbers. And then within this numbers, point this variable to each object every time. So for the first time, when the Python comes into this loop for the first time, the value of this val will be equal to 1. It will iterate the loop second time and now the value will be equal to 2. Similarly, when it comes to the end of the loop and if it reaches to the last, then it comes out of the for loop. So we have achieved the sum of all these values here. 1, then go on and increment the counter. Now within this sum we have 1. Then value will be 2. So 2 plus 1 equal to 3. 3 plus 2 equal to 5 and so on. Finally, when the counter comes to the end, it comes out of the for loop. We have also a range function, where instead of creating a list like this, you can say range 1, 9. So what it does is it creates a list automatically. So see here, print range 10. So what it does is it prints the numbers between 0 and 10. Similarly, prepare a list of this output. So it gives you a list ranging from 0 to 9. And the syntax is like this. Starting value, ending value, and it in between the values, what is the step size? Now see this example here. I want to print a list starting from 2 to 8 and the step size should be 1. If I do not specify any step size, that is the third parameter, it will automatically take 1. And if I specify the step size here in between 2 to 20, I want numbers with a difference of 3 in between them. So first starting with 2, then 2 plus 3 is 5, 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 3 is 11 and so on. So I'm defining my step size also here. Next comes for loop with else. This is very much similar to the while loop with else. Now if the condition in for loop gets negated or if the result of this becomes false, it will directly get into this else block. And we also have this loop control statements. Now you do not want to continue the execution of the loop. So Python has already started executing a loop, while loop or for loop, but you want Python to stop the execution and come out of the loop abruptly. Then you can use the break statement. Now, so for value in string, so what it does is, within this string, you want to iterate every time. And when the value becomes I, you want to break out of that. So first it will go and assign the value of S to this val and that gets printed here. Then value will be equal to T, that gets printed here. Value is equal to R, that gets printed here. Now when value equals I, what am I saying to Python? Break the execution and come out of the loop. So it abruptly ends the execution of the for loop. So similarly continue. If you see this value, then don't do anything, just continue with the next execution. So after achieving the task of printing S, T and R, now the value of I is equal to, so now the value of this variable val is equal to I. So it will come to the statement continue. It will not print the value, but it continues to the next execution. That means now value is equal to N. So that gets printed here. After achieving all this task, it comes to the end of the statement and it prints the end statement here. So continue, what it does is it will continue to the next iteration. It will stop further execution of that code and it will continue to the next iteration. Whereas in break, it will completely stop executing the loop. It will not go to the next iteration. Instead, it will stop the looping of this program. So these both are very important in coming out of looping.